if that is possible. You let off a nuke. Highly recommend. Oh, if they're not going to let us do a nuke above ground, this is what I'm trying to say is what I'm trying to tell you.
Look at that. That's so insane.
Have you done this in Oculus?
No, I have not.
I highly recommend. Oh, if they're not going to let us do a nuke above ground so that we can save ourselves by fear.
Oh, look at that.
Right, this is religious stuff, Joe.
Yeah, it is religious
like stuff. We have announced, if somebody is listening to these tests that we did, my belief is very shortly before you get the ability to traverse the cosmos, if that is possible, you let off a nuke, right? It's like, yeah. It's like, you know, you've had kids. There's some stuff that happens right before they figure out how to break out of the crib.
You know, that's part of UFO folklore, I know, too. Fat Man and Little Boy. That's a big part of UFO, that once they dropped those, that's when all the UFOs started appearing.
So the question is, you know, the analogy I give, so I talked to Avi about the following thing. I am a fan of something I call the doubly scientific method. The usual scientific method makes a hidden assumption that it never voices, which is if we're going to study orcas, we assume that we are smarter than orcas. Or if we're going to study cephalopods, right, like an octopus, we think we're smarter. And what do? We disguise ourselves. We create artificial environments. We do all sorts of crazy things based on the fact that we're smarter than what we study, from everything from rocks to orcas. The doubly scientific method says, okay, assume that you're studying a rat in a maze, but you yourself are the rat in somebody else's maze. Now you have to look up the intelligence scale, not just down. And in the doubly scientific method, you have to assume that whatever is studying you is hiding from you the way you are hiding from your subjects. So if you see somebody in a duck blind, for example, and he's studying ducks, you understand that somebody may be hiding from you. And they might be able to use multiple dimensions of time. They might be able to cloak themselves and disguise themselves. Or for example, if you take microscopic UFOs,